Hey, 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 Scorpio, this is your sacred scribe here, ready to do your Tuesday, August 11th to the 12th intuitive love tarot read. This is for my Scorpion, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Jupiter, and North Node. This will not resonate with everybody, but hopefully you guys can get something out of it today. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe right down below there. Scorpio, if you would, before you leave, I do appreciate it. And thank you so much for all of your likes, shares, and subscriptions. If you guys are interested in a personal reading with me, that way this is more specific to you and your questions and your needs, information is in the description box below. I'm going to get a channeled message for you in just one moment. But first, I'm going to grab a couple of cards here. What's going on for Scorpio? What do you need to know right now? What does Scorpio need to know? One more. All right, so we have the Six of Swords, the Star card, the Seven of Pentacles, the Knight of Cups, and at the bottom of the deck, the Hermit's energy. Let's see what Spirit has for you, Scorpio. Breathe, Scorpio. They're wanting you to consciously breathe more. Slow down. Breathe and slow down. Why? You're going way too fast. With something. They're just showing me somebody that's zip, 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 zipping around. Okay, and not stopping to smell the roses, so to speak, right? Now they're showing me somebody in a bathtub. So they're really wanting you to relax and possibly de-stress. If some of you have been feeling stressed out, they're really wanting you to do these things that will help you. Water is really going to be helpful to you at this time. And they're showing me the salt in the water. So if you can get to the ocean, if you can, just put. They're showing me sea salt in water. So if you're taking a bath, a little bit of sea salt will do you good. Hermit energy. Now this is the energy you need to be in. You need the chill pill. Okay? All right, let's see what's going on here. I feel like Scorpio, for some of you, your confidence is raising, which is a good thing. You're looking back at a time when you felt freer. Because, and it's like you've got this longing to be free from this time that you're looking back to. I'm not sure why. You don't feel free now, besides the obvious in the world, but I don't feel it's that. It's not that. You're seeking this peace, which is good. Because at least that's telling me that you've stopped long enough to know that you want peace. Now, whether or not you're acting on that, I'm not sure. All right, the other reason they want you to slow down is because you have a love offer coming in. So as you're like planting your seeds, right, and waiting for these seeds to grow, and I feel this is business, work, career, something, you may miss this love offer coming. So let's clarify the Star card. Yeah, Seven of Cups. So there's some confusion I feel you have confusion about your dreams and what you want to manifest here with the Magician card here. You want to manifest this peace, right? But it goes back to that feeling of feeling free before, and you feel blocked from that now. You need to connect with the divine because you have multiple sevens here, and that's a divine number for me, which tells me I feel like they're trying to connect with you. So don't ignore the divine. Tell me about the Seven of Pentacles. Six of Cups. This is a past life soulmate. See, this is what you might miss while you're planting these seeds. You need to focus more on the material than you need to focus more on the spiritual than the material. My bad. Yeah, Eight of Wands. This is the eight arrows of love coming at you. But it's going to go right by you, this past life soulmate, if you don't stop to smell the roses here. Ten of Pentacles. This is happiness. This person is bringing happiness, fulfillment, much abundance, loyalty. So what is your advice here? What's your advice as far as this confusion and this freedom go? Why don't you feel free? Like, what's your advice for that? I'm curious to know why you don't feel free. So you have the Two of Wands, the Ten of Swords, and the Page of Swords. Okay. So something's stuck in your field of vibration here, okay? Something, you see how the Ten of Swords have him stuck to the ground, him or her, doesn't matter, and he can't move. This is what you're feeling like. It's either you're not letting go of a memory, and I feel that it's past. It's like before this happened, you felt freer. This experience changed you, and you don't like it. And it's confusing you. You're trying to get back there. You're trying to get back to what was. Okay, but what you need to know is you need to leave this behind. You need to let go and leave it behind and do the inner work to see who you are now. You're only as free as you think you are. Okay, that's a mindset. It's not on the outside. Freedom's on the inside. One more card. There you are. Transformation. Yep. King of Wands and the Three of Cups. Go out. Enjoy yourself. Dates. Do something that's fun. Passionate. Right? This will help you transform and transmute this energy, this confusing energy. Okay? This is going to clear the way for this transformation, and it's going to allow you to see this love offer. Drop your guard. You don't need it. You don't need it. Okay, it's like you're caging yourself up, right? Kind of looks like prison bars. So break free, set yourself free. Okay, all right, Scorpio. I hope this helped. Please drop a like below, share, and subscribe if you already haven't. If you're interested in a personal reading with me, that way this is more specific to you and your needs and your questions. Information can be found in the description box below. Have yourself a fantastic day, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Namaste.